November 18th, Mauricio Herrera always puts on a good show. Pablo Cano, two fighters coming off of losses. That should be a good scrap. November 18th here at the Fancy Springs Resort and Casino. Beth Duran, Doug Fisher, and Steve Kim. Our main event coming up. Peter Petrov, El Czar from Russia, born in Spain, living in Southern California, takes on the artist, Michael Perez. There you see the Puerto Rican flag in the back. His dad with the glasses right there in the black shirt. And he sat down with our Ring TV cameras.
I used to fight a lot in school, not because I picked on people and all that. I used to actually, you know, see other people getting bullied on and stuff like that, and I used to, like, fight for other people. And my father was like, oh, you like to fight, you like to fight, because they used to always call him into school. And he used to come all the time, and he was like, you like to fight, you know what, I'm bringing to the gym. I'm like, all right, bring him to the gym. Went to the gym, and just fell in love with the sport, man. I was doing good. I did my amateur career. I was winning a lot of national titles, and you know, I did a good name for myself in the amateur scene. And then, you know, it was just evident to become pro. I became pro at the age of 18, straight out of high school. Just coming out here, the method that Robert Garcia uses, obviously it works. You know, he got multiple world champs, and that's what I was looking for. And you know, I'm always trying to progress, always trying to be better at what I do. And that's what we're searching for, and that's what we did. And we came out here, and it was all a good idea, I think. You know, and until today, you know, I've won with Robert. I won the NABO title, and now we're fighting for a title eliminator. This is where we want to be. This is a fight that we gotta win to take a hold in the next step of my career. And you know, we're gonna go in there with 100% ready, mentally and physically. And you know, we're gonna win this fight. We're gonna win this fight. I'm very confident that we're gonna win this fight. I got more talent, more tools, more arsenal than Peter Petrov. And I'm ready.
Michael Perez, Michelangelo Perez, actually. That's why the nickname, the artist. And you see Eddie Gomez with it. Watching the homie Artist Perez go to work, rooting for you tonight to get that victory. Also watching Lamont Roach Jr. Lamont Roach, always good at promoting. Turn to Ring Magazine and page 86, November issue, to check him out, Lamont Roach Jr.
Faces. Yeah,
there you go.
Very
Team good. No Excuse, say what's up to the security out there in Washington, D.C. And keep those tweets coming as who's in Paramount right now? Fabian562 watching Ring TV live in Paramount. We appreciate that. And the updated Twitter poll here, Steve.
And also one last one, Patrick Smith. You guys ever had someone fall into your laps? Well, Beto just did.
I just did. And who's going to win the main event? It started with Petrov, then it was Perez, and Martis Perez.
The artist, he's got support.
There it is, 60-40. Go to Golden Boy's Twitter account. You still got a couple minutes. And Ramon Ayala's Tragos Amargo is jamming here at a sold-out Fancy Springs Resort of a Casino. And if it sounds like I'm yelling, it's because it has gotten super loud in
right
here.
And Beto, one note. You asked me November 5th, who was the headliner at Belasco Theater, or just texted Robert Diaz. He says Manuel Tino Avila.
Oh.
Will be on top of that bill.
Good Tino to see him back.
Coming down from Northern California. So keep the tweets coming right now. And, yeah, the tweets about the Gennaro Gomez knockout. Pretty crazy.
No, this needs to be on SportsCenter Top 10. I want to see Beto Duran with the sure hands land on that segment.
You know, the thing is, usually my notes are nice and neat.
Yeah.
They were everywhere, and I have no idea where my pen and highlighter is right now. Take a lot of pride in that highlighter, like Digger Phelps. But nah, it's up here. What do we got?
We're going to watch a highlight of Beto's save. See, Steve, I remember when two heavyweights fought for the first time. I think it was Oleg Moskaev against Hasan Rahman. Moskaev knocked him out of the ring. Now, our play-by-play guy caught the fallen fighter. HBO's play-by-play guy, Jim Lampley,
just kind of watched him slide.
But he was great with the call. It was like, Hasan Rahman has hit the ground right beside me.
Representing Russia. Make some noise for Peter.
Gigi, yep. See, and the thing is,
that says it all.
Because Vernon Alston was able to get up right away under his own power, walk off of the ring, we're able to talk about this right now. But it was an impressive knockout by Gennaro Gomez as our main event fighter are making their way. WBA lightweight title eliminator. Steve, what is exactly does that mean?
That means the winner of this fight will be guaranteed a shot of the winner between the rematch that'll take place next spring between Jorge Linares, who won the title last week, and Anthony Carolla.
I got to tell you what, Petrov already wins points with Doug Fisher entering to
Metallica.
For whom the bell tolls.
You're a rock guy, Dougie?
Metal guy. This is classic metal. This is, I mean, listen, you don't have to be a metal fan to be into Metallica.
Steve's over here dropping Pointer Sisters. You're dropping Metallica.
So what does that say?
We are eclectic. are eclectic here on Ring TV, Duran.
For whom the bells toll.
Man, we're our own boxing Pandora.
This is Petrov's last fight against
Marvin Quintero.
Quintero, and it was a shootout. It was Petrov's right hand versus Quintero's left cross, and it was Petrov doing the more severe damage, earning a stoppage because of the condition of Quintero's eye, and you could see it. You see his left eye right there. It's completely closed, and that's how he won that fight, and that's why he's in position tonight. And as Michael Perez enters the ring.
The artist, Michael Perez, coming in. Newark, New Jersey.
You see the regional belts that he brings into the ring. And both of these guys have won the regional titles, the North American titles, the NABA, the NABO. They've been ready for a long time to step up to this world-class level.
And Doug, you mentioned this earlier. It was about 4 years ago that he was overrun by Omar Figueroa. And then later on, in a fight against Fidel Maldonado in this very same venue, he fell apart late physically. This event center here at Fantasy Springs has been a little bit of a house of horrors for that man, Mikey Perez.
Yeah, he hung on for the win. It was a split decision win against Fidel Maldonado. Maybe a gut check. Maybe that was good for him to have those hard 10 rounds. And he had a string of 10-round decision victories that I think might serve him well if this fight goes the full 12.
Michael Perez. You see Golden Boy President Eric Gomez in the black shirt. Robert Garcia, his trainer.
Whispering last words of wisdom. Garcia, somebody, a trainer who has been here before. A fighter, a former fighter, fought for a world title and won a world title at junior lightweight. So he knows exactly what Perez is going through, what's going through his mind, what's in his heart.
I spoke to Perez a little bit. I wrote a feature on this fight for UCL Live. It's clear they're going to try to box Petrov. They believe Petrov is a strong bull. And tonight that man's going to try to be more or less the matador.
I think that's smart. If you see these highlights from his last fight against Martin Honorio, you look at that cut, and I think eye lacerations, cuts from accidental headbutts, maybe sometimes some legal punches, that's been his Achilles heel. So I think it behooves him to keep his distance, not make it too rough.
Damas y caballeros, este es el combate estelar de esta noche. Pactada a 12 rounds. En un combate eliminatorio por el campeonato mundial de la AMB de los pesos ligeros. And now, ladies and gentlemen, it's about to go down with our main event of the evening. 12 rounds of boxing for the WBA lightweight title eliminator. Sanctioned by the WBA president, sancionado por la AMB, el presidente Gilberto Mendoza. Supervisor in attendance, el supervisor, Miguel Prado. Also sanctioned by the California State Athletic Commission, Commissioner John Carvelli, Executive Officer Andy Foster, Timekeeper Mike Millsap. Your three judges scoring, sus tres jueces, Alejandro Rochin, Max De Luca, y Zachary Young. Y el tercero en la superficie, the third man inside the ring, Eddie Hernandez. Ahora bien, amigos aficionados del boxeo que nos siguen a través de la señal de Estrella TV y los presentes en el Fantasy Springs Resort Casino en Indio, California, Estados Unidos, estamos en vivo. We are live from Indio, California, USA. Ajusten sus cinturones. Introducing to you first, the fighter standing in the red corner, wearing camouflage trunks. His official weight, 135 pounds. Presentando ustedes en la esquina roja, acompañado del entrenador internacional Robert Garcia. Y sus shorts son camuflaje con color negro, con un peso de 135 libras. Professionally, he stands with 24 victories, one loss, two draws, and 11 of those victories coming by the way of knockout. Presenta un récord de 24 victorias, una derrota, dos empates y 11 victorias por la vía del knockout. Boricua de pura cepa, de Newark, New Jersey, Michael the Artist Perez. And his opponent across the ring, standing in the blue corner, wearing red trunks with black and gold. His official weight, 134 pounds. Y su oponente peleando en la esquina azul, vistiendo calzoncillo rojo con negro y dorado, con un peso de 134 libras. Professionally, he holds 37 victories against four losses, two draws, and 17 of those victories coming by the way of knockout. Presenta un récord de 37 victorias, 4 derrotas, 2 empates, y 17 de esas victorias por la vía del knockout. De Ryazan, Rusia, Dami y Gaspada, Pajalosta, Dabro, Pajalovic. Aquí está Peter, el Zar, Petro. Y para dar las instrucciones finales, el referee, Eddie Hernández.
All right, gentlemen, I've been over the rules with you both, and you know what I expect. Touch gloves. Good luck.
And the tail of the tape for our main event tonight, Perez Petrov.
Michael Perez is 7 years younger. He is 3 inches taller, and he has a slight reach advantage.
This one will be 12 rounds in the lightweight division. Get ready to go. Sold out. Fantasy Springs Resort and Casino in Indio, California. Bell rung underway. Michael, the Artist Perez, Michelangelo's name, in the camouflage. Peter Zar Petrov lived in Madrid, Spain, when his parents moved there when he was 12 years old. Now living in Southern California. Petrov's the guy, Steve, correct me if I'm wrong, he's the one who came on a couple years ago because he won that Boxino, right?
Yes, and it's interesting, he actually speaks fluent Spanish.
Speaks it like a Spaniard. Good voice in there.
The Boxino tournament was basically his comeback from a decision loss to Dejan Zlatikanin,
yes,
who is now the WBC lightweight title holder. And no shame in losing to Dejan. Excellent lightweight, probably consensus ranked in the top three in the world.
He's in the red trunks. Michael Perez, Newark, New Jersey. Puerto Rican blood. Won some regional belts. He's a fighter. A couple years ago, just said, that's it, I'm leaving my comfort zone. And he moved with Robert Garcia. Everything about him was comfort. New York, New Jersey. Had some fights in Puerto Rico, trained in Puerto Rico. Never could really find that. And he said, that's it, I'm moving. Liked Robert Garcia's attitude, the way he was approaching things. Moved his camp to Southern California. Now he's the older statesman of that house with a bunch of younger fighters who are 18 and 19. They look up, you're right, they look up to him. He leads by example there.
You know you have a young stable when the old man is 26
yeah.
years old.
Exactly.
That's a young group of boxers.
Yeah, they get out, run everywhere together, do Santa Monica Stairs on Saturdays. They're living and training in Riverside. An interesting matchup. See, I remember reading your piece this week on UCN, and the way you set it up, this is easily a toss-up fight.
It is. I don't think there's any doubt about it. You ask 10 boxing insiders, I don't think it'd be any wider than 6-4. I do get the sense most people think that it is Peter Petrov whose physical strength might be the edge in this matchup.
Yeah, they like his physical strength. They like his durability. They like his last couple of performances. And I think a lot of them just like his maturity and experience. I mean, he's got 43 professional bouts. And he's on a nice little 5-0 run. You see, he's not just about brute strength anymore. He's got craft, and he's very sneaky. Both guys. This is a really interesting first round because both guys have had their moments. Neither guy is in a rush. They're taking this round to take each other's measure, trying to figure out which each guy is bringing to this dance.
But it does seem like Petrov is now finding sneaky ways to land that right hand. I think he's landed the more significant punches here in the first 3 minutes.
Final seconds of the opening round. It is scheduled for 12, an eliminator in the lightweight division. Indio, California is where we are tonight. Home away from home for Golden Boy Promotions. Fantasy Springs Resort and Casino does a great job taking care of us. Usually here once a month. And look at the bio of the sweet graphics for Michael the Artist Perez. Newark, New Jersey.
The NABO lightweight title. Also one of the WBA's minor titles. In 2008, he was the National Golden Gloves lightweight champion. So he was an accomplished amateur. And he's now ranked number 3 in the WBA. Of course, Petrov, 33 years old, from Russia, but has been in Spain, fought 35 times in Spain. His recent fights have been here in the United States, and he has won his share of regional and North American titles, the NABF and the NABA. And he's ranked number 4 in the WBA.
Yeah, Petrov made his U.S. debut in 2014, hasn't left since then. Spain, Portugal, Germany, Argentina, Montenegro.
That's a well-traveled veteran fighter.
And Indio, that's where he's at tonight, taking on Michael Perez. Perez, both of his fights on the East Coast early on in his career. The last two have been in California. Last time was here against Martin Honorio. Good right hand landed by Petrov. Another good right hand by Petrov.
Petrov was looking for that right hand in the first round. He landed it a few times, and I think he's figured out how to deliver it and how to land it. Now he lands with authority.
Petrov, the older fighter, 33.
Oh, there's a cut.
There's blood
on the upper right forehead of Petrov.
Yeah. Was that from a clash?
I think it was from a clash of heads. And there's a cut.
Perez's
yeah,
cut
also
too.
Perez on his right. Oh, gosh, that right eye.
Oh, good right hand landed by Petrov. Oh, down goes Perez. Good right hands, all fight from Petrov. That one caught him, and Perez went down, and Perez is poking at that right eye that is cut. He's had a tendency to get cut in his career. Petrov drops him here in the second. Left hand from Petrov. The Russian, El Czar. Bouncing on his toes. Good left from Petrov. Uppercut Petrov.
Petrov is doing a lot of damage, and I'm not sure that Perez has recovered from that initial overhand right to his temple and the follow-up right that put him down.
30 seconds to go in the second round. Peter Petrov coming in strong. Left. Another left. Perez, I don't know if he ever got his legs back with 15 seconds to go in the second round. There was that earlier clash of heads. Both fighters were cut. Petrov jumped on and landed the bigger right. And Perez poking at that right eyebrow.
He needs to refrain from doing that. He can make it worse. But I think he's wiping blood out of his eye. He needs to be able to see in order to protect himself. He's got to get out of this round. He's got a very good cut man in his corner, but Mike Rodriguez has his work cut out for him.
Yeah, Mike is in Petrov's corner. Robert Garcia.
In Petrov's corner.
Yeah. Robert Garcia is working as a cut man.
Oh, sorry. Robert Garcia has his work cut out for him.
Final seconds. I think they were. Uppercut from Petrov. Petrov did whatever he wants in this round.
Yeah, landing lead power shots from the outside. Uppercuts, left hooks, right crosses. A lot of damage on the face of Michael Perez.
10 seconds
well.
To go.
Good body shot.
Oh, a body shot landed by Petrov.
I may have spoken too soon.
Final seconds of the round. Another good shot landed by Petrov.
Beto, I think that was a left hook to the body that folded Perez, and it was a right hand over the top that really buzzed him. That was a huge round for Peter Petrov.
And there you see Mike Rodriguez, the boxing. The crime-fighting cut man, he's a homicide detective.
Yeah.
Look, Mikey.
And Michael Perez.
This next round, I want you to work on your defense. Okay? Hold them. Make them miss. All right? Don't exchange punches. Recover. All right? I need one more round to recover, right? Just use it to move around.
Close eye. I need to recover this round, all right?
Move around, all right? Move around, hold, make a miss, and hold, all right? You're going to do that?
Get some water, Mike.
Are you going to do that for us?
Yes, sir.
Petrov lands an overhand right, landed on the temple, wobbled Perez, followed up with a right to the jaw, sent Perez down. The left to the body, and that froze Perez momentarily, Steve. Follows up with a right cross. This is towards the end of the round. He had Perez in a lot of trouble.
And I think some very sound advice by trainer Robert Garcia. They want to play a bit of keep away in some four corners. They want to take a round or two to just kind of regain their bearings and get Perez's legs back. But Petrov seems to be coming on very, very quickly here.
And Petrov jumping on it right away. That blood from the right eyebrow of Perez flowing. Uppercut landed by Petrov. A lot of fans in Pomona does Petrov have. They're sending the tweets. Lives in Santa Fe Springs, California now. Body work upstairs. Did Michael Perez hear his trainer?
Yeah, because Garcia said tie him up when he gets in close. He's not doing that.
The Achilles heel of Michael Perez has always been the punch resistance and durability, and it's reared its ugly head. You know, when he faced Quinario.
Oh, big left. That hurt Perez.
Right on.
How is
eye.
He still standing on that one?
Oh, but the eye is spilling blood right now.
Oh.
It's squirting out.
Perez, mouth wide open. Petrov loading up on shots. Elzar is looking good here early in the fight. Body work. Perez doing the opposite of what his corner told him to do. He's trying to gut it out here in the third round.
Well, it's like Perez heard Garcia say, work on your defense, and he took that as to mean no offense. That's not what Garcia meant. Garcia meant tie him up, move if you can move, but don't just stand there and take shots.
Well, guys.
You gotta fire back if nothing else. There, finally he holds.
But Doug, in all fairness, I think Petrov is just overwhelming Perez with some really quick pressure and being much quicker than Martin Lunario is. Listen, you can give all the advice in the world, but if your fighter does not have his bearings or his legs underneath them, it really doesn't matter what you tell him at this stage.
We can't minimize the work that Petrov is doing. I mean, there's a lot of steam on this guy's punches right now, and it's a very nice selection of power shots.
Petrov snapping that jab also.
That's the thing, when he faced Onario, he faced a really slow guy that came at him at the same pacing and rhythm. Petrov has really good quickness this afternoon.
And that Onario fight on the eve of Canelo and Khan, that was one where, Marvin Quintero was cut, and Petrov jumped on it, took advantage of the opportunities.
That's exactly what a fighter's supposed to do. But you see, his arsenal is varied. I mean, he's got body shots, he's got uppercuts, he can lead with power shots. Sometimes he'll be in the southpaw position as he works his way inside. Now he's back to orthodox. He's not easy to figure out. He's not a one-dimensional slugger, as some people have categorized him. He is tough, he is a grinder, but there's a lot of intelligence that comes from that experience that he has.
Final seconds of the round. All Peter Petrov early tonight. In Indio, California, loading up on the shots, landing them, and that'll do it for three. Don't stop believing is jamming right now. Is that what they're telling Perez as we're heading to the fourth?
Petrov was on the attack for the entire duration of round three. Perez was trying to minimize the damage and simply was not able to. Petrov working his way in. There was a nice short right cross. landed by Perez in retreat, but you see the blood dripping from that right eye.
And Eddie Hernandez sending Perez over to the doctor on our notes in front of us. Look at this, guys. There's blood all over our notes right here. As there was a clash of heads in the second round. Doctor says we will continue. Robert Garcia is working as cut man and trainer for Michael Perez. As we go to the fourth, Peter Petroff. Elzar looking good, calling Southern California home. Petroff, body just looks chiseled, awesome. More work, keeps on coming. Going to the bar, attacking, uppercut, doing good. This is a Petroff that looks more fluid and better than he was in the last fight against Marvin Quintero.
No, he also looks quicker. I would say at this stage, Beto, and obviously all three rounds early, have gone against Michael Perez. I think he's gonna have to land something big, almost a Hail Mary punch to really stem the momentum of Petroff, who's just coming on like a locomotive.
He is punching back here in round four, and that's something he wasn't doing in rounds two and three.
There you see Elzar on the side of the trunks of Peter Petroff. Also true boxing head, has the sponsors behind him. Only the United States a few years, got the sponsorship down. There's Peter Petroff, Elzar, born in Ryazan, Russia. Lived in Madrid at the age of 12 with his parents moving there for business. Dropped Perez in the second after that clash of heads. Landing some heavy shots. He's going for that uppercut, isn't he?
Yeah, and he's landing it from mid-range, too. He's leading with the uppercut, which you're usually not supposed to do. It leaves you vulnerable, but he's able to get away with it because Michael Perez's vision is hampered.
Yeah, Sedona, 90377, watching tonight. Appreciate you. Everybody on the Twitter timeline is just impressed with the way that Peter Petroff is looking right now.
He's dishing out a lot of damage in just a few rounds as he gets a different angle to get off at.
And he's attacking the body here in this round.
And he's not just squaring up in front of Perez and grinding it out that way. He's switching his foot placement and attacking from different angles.
Good uppercut from Perez.
Nice right from Perez. He needs more like that.
Here comes Petroff. Interesting to see how that cut on the right eye of Perez is going to affect him later on.
Doug, he's landing punches here and there, Perez, that are very clean, but I think he's going to need a fight-changing punch to really turn this fight. It's all going one way. And I tell you, Petroff is just relentless with this pressure.
There's not much power behind Perez's shots.
Well, it's been punched out of him, Beto. Let's just be very honest. I mean, I don't think his legs have been underneath him since that second round knockdown.
Right, his equilibrium was affected before he actually hit the deck in that second round. And we've got to take into consideration the body attack from Petroff. That's going to take a lot of steam off your shots.
You know what? I give Perez credit. I don't think he's won this round, but he's been very game here in the fourth.
He's a gutsy fighter.
Slick Rick jamming. Fifth round coming up. And that's the corner of Michael Perez.
You're taking too much, Mikey. I don't want to see you get hurt, amigo. I think it's too much. Me personally, I think it's too much. Okay? I think it's too much, amigo. Huh?
I'm good.
I don't want to see you get hurt.
It's gotta be the way you finished it.
That's the only, I'm gonna give you this round, all right? The weather is the round.
It's gotta be exactly like that.
Cierres and just go throw your hard punches, but keep your chin down and bend your knees and back him up. This one round, that's all I'm gonna give you, all right? Okay?
You need this round, Mike. I'm gonna give you this round.
Robert Garcia trying to stop the fight. Michael Perez talked himself into one more.
Well, now, this is why we're seeing highlights from round four, and you see the uppercuts and the damage these uppercuts are doing to Michael Perez's face. We're also seeing the body work from Petroff, which has been good throughout the fight.
And Beto, as you alluded to, I think Robert Garcia wanted to halt the action, throw in the towel. I think Mike Perez has 3 minutes here to change the mind of his trainer.
I don't think he's going to get 3 minutes. I think Robert is going to pay attention quickly because the way that Petroff had just come out right away, jumping on him. Robert's going to be quick to protect his young 26-year-old fighter. And Perez still looks like he has that glazed eye effect.
And we had a competitive feel-out opening round, but Petroff felt what he felt, saw what he saw, and jumped on Perez at the start of round two, and it's been all Petrov since.
Also, Perez's dad in the corner with Robert Garcia.
Doug, I think we have identical scorecards of 40 to 35, and I think Robert, being an honest guy, I think he must have the same scorecard. I think certainly that will paint a certain perspective as a trainer whether to allow this to go on too much further.
Yeah, Garcia is not scoring rounds. He's just looking at the cumulative damage on his fighter's face, and he knows from being a fighter himself the damage that body shots do.
And that's the danger of facing a hard-charging grinder like Petrov. He may not erase you with one punch, but he will just consistently erode you round after round with a selection of hard punches to the head and body.
Don Jose Vitela, the man from Durango in Monterey Park, said this isn't going 12. That's his message. I think Peter Petrov trying to listen to him. Petrov just relentless.
Well, and you see the underrated footwork when he's in close. He never just stands in front of Michael Perez. He gets off with heavy shots to the body and head, and then takes a step to the right or to the left and gets off again.
Is that where that rope work comes in, Steve, where the guys are doing the back and forth, the body work?
You know, a lot of that is the upper body movement, but a lot of this you have to be trained and drilled into as your trainer overlooks. You could do that with the heavy bag. You could do that with the big circular pad. Oh, and he got caught right there.
Perez showing some heart. And the big shot, a minute to go in the fifth. Yeah, from Perez. Trying to show some life in those legs now. Here's Michelangelo Perez.
I got to give Perez a lot of credit. Just looking at him, he's doing everything he can not to drown in there.
He's trying to tread.
No, he is. I mean, listen, right now he's like that guy who's 50 yards from shore who's really engulfed. And the question is, will he be pushed to the bottom? He actually landed a good right hand there on Petrov.
Petrov's movement is impressive.
No, it's perpetual motion. It really is.
10 seconds to go in the fifth round. Scheduled for 12. A bloody Michael Perez down in the second. Getting worked here by Peter Petrov in an eliminator in the WBA lightweight division.
Roll. Remember, all the way. Okay.
Hey, guys, don't let me get involved. Put the hitting behind the head, okay?
He's doing it.
They're holding it.
Yeah, bring it low.
Follow. Okay. Ahorita cuando empiecen round uno, un golpe. ¿No yo?
When the round starts, one body shot.
Fuerte.
Hard.
Mike. Cuando empiece el round, fuerte. Okay?
When the round starts strong.
Okay?
He got tired, Mike said.
Where's yo?
Ya está cansado,
ya no tiene nada,
Mike.
Ya no tiene nada.
He yo, Mike. He gave it all in the first couple rounds.
He's tired. He gave it all early on the fight.
Perez landing a right to the body. But Petrov coming back with both hands to the body as they grapple, lock arms on the inside. Petrov with the short uppercut on the inside. Got clipped with the right cross from Perez. So Perez did well enough to convince Robert Garcia to keep him in the fight. See what happens here.
Sixth round, scheduled for 12. Body low blow, Michael Perez.
And Garcia wanted him to go hard to the body early in this round, but
could that have been intentional? Could that have been intentional by some time?
You know, I remember a fight between Fernando Vargas and Felix Trinidad, when Vargas seemed to have all the momentum and a punch straight low. Things like that, Beto, absolutely can be very, very strategic.
There's a lot on the line right here. Eliminator, the winner goes and gets a shot at the world title. You're desperate.
I tell you what, Petrov recovered very fast. He didn't get much of a reprieve if that was intentional.
Not that it was, I'm just saying.
Yeah, no, it's, hey, listen, it's possible, but.
Good clock. Good exchange between the two. More blood coming down the right eye of Perez. That was cut early in the second. Uppercut from Petrov. He's in the red. The Russian Spaniard. Right hand. Double right. Perez looks tired.
These punches have taken a lot out of him. Petrov's one of these guys. He's not fast. He's not fast, and his punches don't appear that crisp, but they're heavy. He's just got one of these guys who's a methodical guy who does a lot of damage.
He's like throwing in volley mouth.
Yeah. Yeah.
Hands are free, guys.
Body work. Good.
That was a hard left to the body.
Right from Petrov. Standing in the middle.
I like that here and there Perez is trying to go to Petrov's body, but he's just being soundly outworked round after round.
Perez is game. He's gutsy, but quite frankly, it looks like he's outgunned.
Is this a step up in competition for Perez?
Well, if you look at the history of Perez, and again, all of this has happened here in Fantasy Springs. He was overrun by the physicality of Figueroa, fell apart late against Fidel Maldonado. This was the big question, was his durability against a hard man like Petrov. And I got to tell you, looking at Garcia, he looks very concerned. If it's in my mind, I'm thinking to myself, he probably hasn't won a round, things aren't getting any better, and you're facing a hard-charging guy. You may want to start thinking about pulling out that towel.
He was trying to do it two rounds ago. Right from Perez, answered by two from Petrov. Final seconds of the round. Been all Peter Petrov tonight in Indio. Oh. Yeah, exactly. Oh, Lil Mana is jamming. Oye, mi amor. That's the song that gets every person all fired up. This song right here, guys, when you play like at a Mexican wedding or quinceañera or backyard party, every dancing. Girl starts dancing, and the guys are like, yeah, I guess I'll go too.
That's it, guys.
And it is over. The fight is over. Robert Garcia has stopped it. Protect his young fighter.
Yeah, good stoppage, good decision by Robert Garcia. And it lets me know that Robert Garcia is growing as a trainer. He received a lot of criticism 6 years ago in Texas, in Arlington, Texas, by allowing Antonio Margarito to go 12 against Manny Pacquiao.
You know, that's the toughest decision, to not allow a fighter to get beat twice, once for that night and once for the rest of his career. I think that stoppage is very prudent. It allows Mike Perez to fight another day.
And Perez argued with Robert at the end, shook hands with his trainer. Now the two fighters are shaking hands in the middle of the ring. It was a good scrap. Went at it. I came away really impressed with how Peter Petrov looked. Elzar is taking a step up.
He looked better tonight than he did in May against Marvin Quintero.
Yes, he did.
We saw a lot more wrinkles to his game.
Doug, whoever wins that rematch between Jorge Linares and Corolla, they got a tough customer awaiting him in Peter Petrov.
And we're going to see, these highlights are going to tell us why. You'll see right there, he keeps grounding. This was round six, the final round of the bout. And you see, even when Perez blocks like an uppercut, there's a left hook to the body following it. He's always putting his punches together, Petrov is. And they're all heavy shots.
If you look at this division, guys, your champions are Linares, Robert Easter, Dejan Zlatikinen, Terry Flanagan. Then you have contenders like Denis Shafikov, Juan Diaz, Ray Beltran, Jose Felix, and Verdejo.
Mikey Garcia is in that mix. The lightweight division is very deep. It's varied. It's a hot weight class in boxing right now.
And there you see him talking with Golden Boy president Eric Gomez. Frustrating night for Michael Perez, but his trainer, Robert Garcia, as you mentioned, growing as a trainer. And this is somebody who's in his house every single day, knows him. Tried to stop the fight a couple rounds ago. Perez talked himself into more time, but at the end of the day, he just avoided the inevitable.
It's a hard position for the trainer to be in because he's right there sacrificing with his fighter. He knows how long and how hard Michael Perez has worked since suffering the first loss of his career 4.5 years ago. I mean, unbeaten over his last 10 bouts. He doesn't want to stop it, but he also cares about him as a fighter and as a human being.
Well, also, in like 27, 28 fights, Michael Perez only has 11 knockouts, so he doesn't have that proverbial eraser. And I think, again, that's a variable that you have to factor into. Is my guy a Julian Jackson type of puncher that can make up for a lot of mistakes? Petrov has only been stopped by one guy, a very heavy-handed Marcos Maidana, I believe at 140-something.
Yes.
So I did not see this thing changing anytime soon. I think Robert Garcia made the tough decision, but the only one that really needed to be made.
You're right. He's only been stopped once. That was at Marco Maidana in 2011. The other losses, most recently, to John
Batikinen.
And then before that, early on in his career.
Right.
So it's not like he's also a fighter who's going to get caught by standing there doing something dumb. And it looked like Petrov was getting stronger as the...
He's all about conditioning. You know, he is. He's a grinder, but when we say grinder, don't mistake grinder for one-dimensional. Right, or flat-footed. He's actually got pretty decent footwork. He's not nimble in there. He's not Jorge Linares.
You know,
but he's a very dangerous, legitimate lightweight contender, and he's dangerous for Linares if Linares wins that rematch for Corolla, because even though Linares is a full level above Michael Perez, he has the same Achilles
heels. Roja abandona la pelea al final del round número 6 by the red corner stoppage at the end of round number 6. Your winner by the way of knockout. Su ganador por la vía del knockout y avanzando por el campeonato mundial de peso ligero de la AMB. Peter El Zar Petrov.
El Zar, no que no tronabas, there he is, gets the job done. Madrid, Spain, Ryazan, Russia, Southern California. Peter Petrov gets the victory tonight.
As we hear Metallica, the classic heavy metal, and Petrov looks like he's made out of heavy metal.
He is sculpted out of steel.
Really?
Petrov's promoter is a gentleman by the name of Arti Palulo. Now, he is the one who came up with the Boxino format, and the biggest star that Boxino has ever produced was Acelino Copo Frietis. But this tournament here throughout the years has consistently provided a springboard. Willie Monroe won the middleweight tournament a couple years ago.
And now he's a player in the middleweight division.
Basically got a fight with Golovkin, and I think Petrov is the next guy from that Boxino format. Looks like he's going to get a very, very significant opportunity very soon.
Seven fights in the books. It was a good night of boxing in Indio, California. Basti Samir started it off, unanimous decision. Jonathan Navarro, decision. Then the knockouts came. Javier Padilla, Indio, California, second round stoppage. Luis Coria, second round. Alexis Rocha, first round. Gennaro Gomez, first round. And Peter Petrov with a TKO in the sixth round. We'll be back in Indio November 18th. The next Golden Boy production on Ring TV will be next Friday
at the
Belasco
Theater.
Make sure you get the tickets, always sells out. And then November 7th will also be at the Belasco Theater, Tino Avila. And as always, do appreciate all the tweets from everybody on Ring TV. I think we're gonna talk to Petrov, but we're gonna find that out. We'll be back with more. You're watching Ring TV, production of Golden Boy Promotions in Indio, California. Are you now Fantasy Springs Resort and Casino. Good night of action as El Czar Peter Petrov is making his way over after shaking hands, talking to the promoters. Aquí siéntate, viejo. Aquí está una toalla. Aquí quieres. We got everything for you, baby. Tenemos todo. Lo que necesitas, aquí tenemos. As El Czar Peter Petrov sitting down. Luis, stage managing deluxe, is getting in here. We're going to fix that microphone. Ahí está la cámara, si quieres mirar.
Hola, amigo.
Todo. Yeah. Okay. ¿Qué pasó en esta pelea? Saliste muy fuerte. You came out really strong in this fight. ¿Ese era el intento? Was that the intention?
Sí, he confiado en mi campamento. Hemos hecho un gran trabajo con mi entrenador y manager, Denis Zamora. Y hemos contratado un nuevo coach, physical coach, Jerry Arias. Y gracias a ellos he venido al 200% físicamente. Y tenía que salir desde el primer round hasta el round número 15 o 20 y sacar golpes. Y estaba preparado, estaba confiado en mi trabajo y así lo hemos hecho. Sabíamos que él iba a abandonar, que no iba a aguantar mi ritmo y así pasó.
Said a lot there, so I'm trying to get you there with that Spanish accent. He hired a conditioning coach for this one and he was prepared to go 1 through 15 rounds and then he knew that Perez wasn't going to be able to stay with him. Sabías que no iba a aguantar toda la pelea. You knew
sí,
he wasn't going to.
Sí, ese era el plan. Sabíamos que no iba a aguantar esa pelea porque él es un gran boxeador, pero le he visto sus peleas y nunca le he visto con boxeador como yo que esté pegando los 3 minutos de cada round.
Yeah, he's a good fighter. I've seen his fights, but he's never been one that has gone the full distance and he's never gone up against somebody who has my strength. And ahora tienes una oportunidad de pelear contra Jorge Linares. ¿Cómo te sientes con eso?
Sí, la verdad es un orgullo para mí. Yo siempre he seguido la carrera de Jorge Linares y siempre he dicho que es el mejor boxeador en peso ligero. Cuando él estaba en 130 libras, yo boxeaba 130 libras y quería esa pelea, pero nunca salió. Y ahora tenemos la oportunidad, gracias a esta pelea, gracias a WBA por esta eliminatoria. Gracias a mis promotores por conseguir esta eliminatoria y tenemos esa oportunidad. Ojalá, espero que es un gran campeón y espero que me dé esa ansiosa pelea por el título mundial.
I've always followed Jorge Linares' career. I always thought he was one of the best at 130. And when he was fighting 130, I always wanted that fight. It never happened. And thank you everybody that now there's an opportunity to fight against Jorge Linares. Última pregunta, last question. How do you feel right now? ¿Cómo te sientes?
I feel so happy.
Oh,
I,
wait, wait. You speak English?
Nah, a little
oh,
bit.
Oh, man.
I had,
No. They told me no English.
I had a great training camp with my trainer, and I'm so happy. We did it.
All right. Ahora traduce eso. Translate that.
Ya, hemos hecho un gran trabajo con mi entrenador y confiaba en mi victoria y lo hemos hecho, lo hemos logrado. Gracias a todo mi equipo. Sin ellos no es posible. Y gracias a mi mujer, a mis patrocinadores. Gracias a todos. Gracias a España, Rusia, Rusia, le vas.
Oh, ¿sabes qué? ¿Bratán?
Bratán y Lavas.
¿Druk?
Druzia, Lavas.
¿Robot Chai?
Viva México, cabrones.
El Czar, Peter Petrov, le ganó a Michael Perez. That's probably one of my best interviews.
Un abrazo a puertorriqueños, que son una gran gente, gran aficionado al boxeo.
Pues felicidades.
Todos, gracias.
El Czar, Peter Petrov, habla todos los idiomas. He speaks way too many languages. We'll be back with more English only in Indio, California.
Thank you.